lovelies, you're welcome back to my YouTube channel. Thank you so much for clicking in. Please, if you are new to this channel, kindly do well to subscribe to our YouTube channel and also endeavor to click on the notification bell, as this enables you to get notified whenever new tutorials are uploaded. To all our old subscribers, thank you so much for subscribing. Thank you for watching our videos. In today's tutorial, we are going to be learning how to make this gathered or pleated turban cap, which has this embellished pleated design attached on it. The materials needed include scuba fabric, of which 1 yard will be enough, your scissors, your measuring tape, your matching color of thread and needle. You'll also be needing bony, be needing gum, and then as any accessory, applique or trimming for embellishment. This design we are working on has two parts. First is the turban cap, which is the gathered or pleated turban cap, of which you can use any other turban cap in place of it. Secondly is the pleated design that is attached to it. Before now, I've had my fabric cut out, so I'm going to be illustrating how to go about it and also stating out the measurements that are required. We'll be starting with the turban cap first, of which I'll be using a different video to illustrate. And as soon as we're done with that, we'll go ahead to proceed with the design.
I'm going to be starting by stating out the measurements I'm going to be using now. I have my fabric here, and this fabric is for my band. For my band, I'm going to be using 5 inches for the width and 23 inches for the length, which is the head circumference. So from this end to this end is 5 inches, while the full length is 23 inches, which is 5 inches by 23 inches for the band. Now for the base, I have my fabric cut out already, and I'm also going to be using 23 inches for the head circumference, like that of the band, while the width is going to be 18 inches. So for my base, I'm using 23 by 18 inches, which is 23 inches for the head circumference and 18 inches for the width. Now, as having done that, get your base, get your measuring tape and your chalk. The way my fabric is positioned, from this end to this end is 18 inches, which is the width. I'll take it again. From this point to this point is the 18 inches, the width. While from this end down to this other end is the head circumference, which is 23 inches. To continue, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to get my measuring tape, and then I'm going to be measuring out 1.5 inch, and I'm going to be marking it. So I'll measure 1.5 inch and mark until I get to the end of the fabric. So I have 1.5 inches here, and I'm going to be marking. I'll continue, measure another 1.5 inch and mark. Continue, take another measurement of 1.5 inches and mark. So this is what I will do till I've gotten to the end. As soon as I've gotten to the end of the fabric, I'm also going to extend this my mark, this my measurement, down to this other end here. So I'll extend it from this point down to this other end. So I'll do that and I'll get back. Having done that, this is what I have. As you can see, my marks, my lines are here, and each interval is 1.5 inch. So this is what I've done. I started from this point and I have it down all the way to the end of my fabric. Now to continue, I'm going to take it to my sewing machine, and I'm going to be folding it and sewing by 1/2 inch. So I'll pick the first line, fold it down this way, fold it into this way, and sew by half an inch from this end down to the other end. I'll pick the second mark, fold again, sew by half an inch from this point down to the other point. I'll come again, pick the third mark, fold it and sew. And then that is how I'm going to sew until I get to the last mark, which I have here. That is this last mark here. I would also fold and sew until I get to the end. So I'm going to get this on my sewing machine. I'll sew and I'll get back. Sewing, and this is what I get. This is the wrong side of my fabric. Now, this was what I meant when I said you pick each line, you fold into two, and you sew from this end down to the other end. You pick the second line, fold into two, and then sew from this, sew by half an inch from this end down to the other end until you get to the end of your fabric. So this is it. This is the back view after stitching. And then this is the front view. So this is how it looks like. This is how my work is. I'm going to continue. I'll get my band. And then I have my band here. I'm going to be folding my band into two this way. So this is it. After folding into two, this is what I get. And then I'm going to be placing my band on the fine side of my base. So I'll fold into two and place on the fine side of my base this way. I'm going to be holding it down using my pins. As soon as I'm done holding it down in place with my pins, this is what I get. This is how it looks like. So this is it from this other side. And then I'm going to place it on my sewing machine. And I'm going to sew from this end. I'll start sewing from this end. I'll sew all the way down to this other end to join my band and my base together. So this gather to band cap is a round band gather to band cap. So I'm going to sew from this end down to the other end, and as soon as I'm done sewing, I'll get back and show us how it looks like. At this point, I've been able to join my band to my base. This is my band and this is my base. This is the back view. This is where I joined the band to the base. So this is how it looks like. And then my band cap is getting ready. To continue, I'm going to be folding my work into two this way. Now I'm going to be joining everything together to form the cap. So I'll place it on my sewing machine, starting from the band. I'm going to sew from this end. I'll sew down. On getting to this end, I'll also take it down this way till I've gotten to this end. So this is how I'm going to sew from this point down. Getting to this point, I'll also take it to this other side till I've gotten to this end here. So I'm going to place it on my sewing machine and sew, then I will get that back. Sewing, this is what I get. You can see I started stitching from this way. I'm getting here, I brought it down this way to this very end, and I'm done stitching. This is the back view. Now I'm going to turn it inside out to the front view. So this is it. This is the side I was sewn. The ends are closed and I have this. Now I'm going to get the middle part. And then this is my middle part. This is the middle part of my fabric. Okay, I had to make a fence line so that I can be sure of it. I don't know if you can see it. There's a fence line at the middle here. And then to continue, I'm going to be stitching through the middle part to form my gathers. I will proceed by getting my needle and thread. I have my needle and thread here, and then ensure your thread is doubled so that it can help hold your fabric in place. At the middle point, pass your needle and thread from the back of the fabric, that is from inside the fabric. Bring it out this way. Now take it back inside. It should be very close to where your thread is coming out from. Now take it back inside and then pass your needle and thread to the next line that was sewn. So this is it. I have my needle here and it's out. So what I'm going to do again is that I'm going to repeat the same procedure I did for the first line that was sewn. I'll pass my needle and thread inside again, very close to it, and then bring it out from inside. It's out. And then I'll pass my, so by the time you drag your thread, you see you're already forming your gathers. And then I'll pass my needle and thread again to the third line. Please, it should be at the middle. That was why I made fent lines to guide me. Pass my needle and thread out. And then I'm going to take it back inside, very close. And then bring it out from the fourth line that was sewn. That is the next line that was sewn. And I'll repeat the same procedure until I get to this very end here, the tip here. I've cut off my excess thread and I have my gathers here. So this is going to be the front view of our cap and this is the back view. Now to continue, flip your work to the back, that is turn it inside out to the other side, and then along this edge here, using your needle and thread, we'll be making a running stitch. Now your running stitch comes immediately after the band. We're not making the running stitch on the band, but after the band, that is at this point, we're going to make a running stitch down to this end and we'll end here. We'll not extend it to this other part. It's going to end here. My needle and thread here. Now, starting immediately after the band, I'm going to pass my needle and thread in and I'll start making my running stitches. So I'll just take my needle and thread in, out, until I get to the end. Finally, this is what I get. So this is my gathers at the back, my gathers at the front, and then turning it to the front. This is how it looks like. So my gathered turban cap.
I have mine already sewn. I'm working with the gathered or pleated turban cap. And then that is it for that. Secondly, coming over to the design, I have my fabric cut out already. And the measurement for my fabric is 20 inches by 20 inches. I have 20 inches by 20 inches. So I'm going to get this on my sewing machine and I'm going to sew all four edges. I'm going to be sewing to cover the fraying edge. But before then, we're going to be adding boni on both sides. Now I have my boni cut out here, two pieces, and the measurement for each piece is 18 inches. So what I'm going to do is, there are two methods for doing this. First and foremost, this is 18 inches. And then I'm going to add my boni to my fabric. Then I'm going to fold my fabric in and then sew it down, okay? Or better still, I can fold my fabric in and sew. And after sewing, I'll pass my boni inside. Now the boni is thin on the left side and on the right side. And I'm also folding this edge
in order to cover the rough edges. So I'm going to go over to my sewing machine to sew, and after sewing I'll get back. So this is it. I've been able to fold in this edge and I've sewn, and the same thing applies to this other edge. And then I'm going to get my bone and I'm going to be adding it on each side. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and then pass this in. The same thing applies to this other side. I'll get the second bone and I'll pass it in all the way to the end. And as soon as I'm done with that, I'm going to go over to my sewing machine and then also fold in this edge and sew it down, and also fold in this other edge and sew it down. Then I'll get back. And then I'm done sewing. I have my boning on my right side and my left side. And I've also folded in this part and then folded in this part. Right, and what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be pleating my fabric. While the boning will be at the side, I'll be pleating the up and the lower part. So this is me. I'm trying to pleat my fabric now. And then on getting to the end, I'm going to hold this down. So I'll just tie it in place before getting my needle and thread to tack it down. And then I have my needle and thread here. So I'm just going to tack it down a couple of times. Please ensure that your tacking is at the middle of your design. So I'm going to go back and tack this by passing my needle and thread in and out several times. And when I'm done, I'll get back for us to continue. So as soon as I'm done tacking, I have this way. I'm going to go ahead and get my turban cap, and I'm going to be placing it on one side of my turban cap, and I'm going to be tacking it down. Before doing this, like I would always say, place this on your dummy head to get your fitting, and then go ahead to use your needle and thread to tack it down. Now, tacking is the same way as I did earlier for this part. I'll keep passing my needle and thread through in and out of the fabric. So I'll pass my needle and thread from inside the turban cap down to this pleated design, and then take it back several times until it is secured. At this point, I'm done tacking. I've tacked down the design down to the base. And then if you see this, at this point, I extended the tacking down here. Also, I extended the tacking down here. So I tacked down this part so it can stay firmly to the base. Now, I'm going to go ahead to set my design in place properly. And then I'm all going to be placing one end on the other. And I'm going to be tacking it down together this way so that it can sit well. Now, or then still take it down further this way. So I'll take it down further this way and tack this edge down together. Then I'm going to now set this part in place. Now when it comes to the edge, you can embellish. Let me hold down this part with my pin first. Just if you don't want the sewing stitch to be visible, you can get your trimming, any trimming of your choice. And then apply gum on it and go ahead to glue it round this way, and that will cover the stitches. I'm going to be tacking it down together this way so that it can sit well. And as soon as I'm done tacking, I'll go over to embellish with any accessory of my choice, then I'll place it on my dummy head to show us the final outlook. So this is my work, and I'm done tacking. Now coming down to embellishment, I have this flower accessory which I can place here, or I can as well make use of my brooch and then place it here. So whichever you prefer, whatever accessory you have for embellishment, you can go ahead to do that and then place it at the middle, or you can as well decide to leave it this way. It depends. I have this. All I have to do is to apply gum. I have my UAG gum, and then I'm going to apply gum, then place it across this way to glue it down together, and I'm going to set everything down properly in place. Now, you don't want to use an applique that is too heavy. Okay, don't use an applique accessory that is too heavy and then place it at the middle. If not, your design is not going to stand properly. You need something that can match with the weight of the design so that the design can stand when worn on the head. So that is it. Now I'm going to finish tacking this end and I'm going to apply gum and then I'm going to set this and then glue this down across this way. And I'll get back to show us the finished outlook of our design.
So this brings us to the end of today's tutorial. Thank you so much for watching. If there are any questions, please kindly let us know. Do well to like, please share, and also don't forget to leave a comment in the comment section. If you have tutorials you'd like us to upload, please let us know by leaving a message for us. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook and on Instagram. We are there as Jenny Concept. Bye.